as of now, the DFE has facilitated the repatriation because the IATF tasked the DFA to take care of the repatriation of 54,736 overseas Filipinos from 57 countries and 110 cruise ships. 30,645 are sea-based OFWs, and we thank the local manning agencies and of course they're the owners of the cruise ships for taking care of the expenses. But the land-based OFs are they are 24,091. Just to give an overview, the Assistance to Nationals Fund of 1 billion of the DFA has been overstretched already. We have spent, as of June 23, 66% of our fund, and we are afraid if we continually charter the planes, because there are a lot more people who are stranded, that our funds will run out by the end of August. And actually, Your Honors, the Assistance to Nationals Fund is not only for COVID-19. In fact, we did not foresee that there was going to be a COVID-19. That's why we have been overspending, and we have spent almost 197 million for COVID-19 assistance. The estimated number of stranded Filipinos is 167,626. We have to bring them home in the next 2 to 3 months. As much as we want to bring them home in just one go, we have restrictions from CAAP, and also we are given restrictions daily on how many people we could bring home, because we do not want them to be stranded in Metro Manila and other quarantine facilities. And also the problem of the testing kits, because there might be we are sometimes running out of testing kits, Your Honors. So we are calibrating the repatriation, but we expect to bring home 27,466 OFWs in the next 3 weeks. Thank you very much, Your Honors. And I think just for an overview, the biggest, the two places that has the most number of stranded Filipinos are Saudi Arabia and UAE, 88,000 in Saudi Arabia and 50,000 in UAE. The biggest problem in Saudi Arabia is Riyadh alone is bigger than the Philippines. So it's very difficult for our foreign service posts to respond to the needs of our OFWs because of sheer size, the lockdowns, and also the lack of manpower. And unfortunately, our Polo office has been shut down because there are 16 infected of COVID-19. And there's also, we are also having problems with infections in Jeddah, in our foreign service post. But we are just assuring everyone that we're doing our very best.